Hello, my friends. So today we're going to be talking about something extremely important. The greatest mission of all time, the most important mission, the most important work ever that needs to be done. It's a massive job. Now think about this. The Lord Jesus Christ died and came back to life 2,000 years ago for the whole world, for everybody in the world's salvation, for everybody to be at peace with God, for everybody to be justified from sin, for everybody to have eternal life. And yet, there are still so many people who are not saved by God's grace. Why? Why is this? The problem here, my friends, is that so many people haven't heard. God's salvation plan for everybody in the whole world, nobody left out, has been here on our planet for 2,000 years, and there are still so many people who have not heard the good news of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's look at how big this problem really is. We've got a map here and here, and we have a globe right here. Here, as you can see. But what is this really all about? There are still so many people who haven't heard about the Lord Jesus Christ. All over the world, millions upon millions of people. Let's look at some of the areas of the world where people seriously need to hear and haven't heard yet. Let's look at some of the biggest areas where the need is desperate to hear about the good news of the love of the Lord Jesus Christ. We've got our globe here. Now, one of the biggest areas in the entire world that has not heard the good news is the Middle East and North Africa. Now, you see right here, the Middle East, right here, which includes countries like Egypt, Jordan, Saudi Arabia, Yemen, Oman, the UAE, Qatar, Bahrain, Kuwait, Iraq, Syria, Turkey, Iran, and yeah, and not really Israel, because what kind of Israel, but, and yeah, so these countries are mainly Muslim, and you can learn about Islam in our last episode and why it's not true, but basically these countries do not have the good news. They lack the good news. They have not heard. Very few of these countries have heard. This is the very area where the gospel first started and first spread. But the problem is now it's inundated with Islam and very few people have even heard because it is very dangerous to get the good news in. An area of the world that Satan literally has in his grasp. And because of that, he uses fear to keep people from even getting in there and preaching the good news. And even the few times that the good news is preached in those countries, people who get saved in those countries, it's extremely dangerous for them. They are under threat of being totally rejected by their families, even being thrown in jail, even killed. It is not safe. So this area of the world is in Satan's grasp. The very area where the gospel first started is bound by Satan's own tricks. And that is a truly sad thing. The world that has been severely withheld from hearing the good news is the countries of North Africa. Countries that are also mainly Muslim, like Mauritania, Western Sahara, Morocco, Algeria, Tunisia, Libya, Egypt also included, Sudan, Chad, Niger, these kind of countries, Mali, even a lot of countries in Western Africa that are mainly Muslim, Senegal, these type of countries, mainly Muslim countries, they have, and even Somalia and the Horn of Africa, many places in the Horn of Africa, Somalia down here, these countries have had so little of the good news for the same reasons as the Middle East. It's terrifying. It's so hard to get in. But this is God's good news. People need to hear. What if somebody was afraid to tell our ancestors? For we too are Gentiles, and our ancestors opposed God's law in every way imaginable. What if somebody was scared to tell our ancestors the good news? What state would we be in? We would not have heard. This is why fear must not be an option. We must tell people the good news of the Lord Jesus Christ. Some of the areas that really got the good news, let's see, it started here in Israel because Jesus lived in Israel, and the good news kind of spread around to the Middle East, and the Apostle Paul, he went around to Europe, to places like Greece and Italy and places where like modern day Croatia is. He mentioned in Romans chapter 15, he went to Illyrium, which is basically where Albania-ish is, that area. And it spread throughout Europe, and then it went up here to, you know, Britain and all these things. And then after that, it went all over to this side of the world and down to South America.
And so here, mainly these areas in Europe have had the good news, but it is for everybody. And this has created the myth that it is only white man's religion. But the real reason that it is only in areas where mostly white people are or Latino people are is because people, as Christians, we have not been as diligent as we should have been in spreading the good news. Now, in the 1800s, many Christians decided we seriously need to get this good news out. This is not only for us, this is for everybody. So many missionaries went to Africa, they went to India, they went to China, they went to all these different places. But many places around the world are still lacking. There are many areas, many tribes in Africa that have not heard the good news. There are many tribes in the Amazon that have no clue about the gospel. There are many, many villages, many people, millions of people in India who have not heard. Central Asia, who have not been reached with the good news, because in Central Asia, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Uzbekistan, Turkmenistan, Tajikistan, Afghanistan, Pakistan, these countries are mainly Muslim as well, and they have not heard. Western China, in the province of Xinjiang, is inhabited by the Uyghur people, which are mainly Muslim as well. And there are many pockets of places all down here that have not heard, mainly Buddhist places in Southeast Asia and Indonesia. Many Muslim people have many tribal religions as well. They have not heard the good news. And there are pockets all over the world, people who have not heard. This is a terrible state of affairs.
What does the Bible say will happen to people if they do not believe? The Bible says they will be thrown into the lake of fire. Why? Why do we die in our sins? Why do people go to hell? People get mad at God about this a lot. They say, well, just because someone didn't hear about Jesus, they're going to burn forever. That doesn't seem fair. But here's the deal, my friends. We don't go to hell because we didn't hear about Jesus. We go to hell because we sin. We break God's law. And everybody, no matter if you've never heard, everybody, me, you, everybody, we deserve to go to hell because we've all broken God's law. So everybody in the world is automatically, by default, going to hell because we automatically, by default, sin. And we know that's true. This is why we need Jesus. We who have heard about him have been saved by him, and others need to hear about him too. Some people say, well, just because, since other people haven't heard, God is kind and he'll let them go to heaven. But then why would God tell us to preach in the first place? Because that would mean that we're giving people an opportunity to go to hell, because then we're giving people an opportunity to choose or reject. So obviously we are already going to God's judgment. That's the whole point of why the gospel is a thing. If that was the truth, if that was reality, that God would just let people who haven't heard go to heaven anyways, then God should never have sent salvation, because we could all just go to heaven anyways because we never heard of him. But no, that's not how it works. We are going to hell. God is angry at us because we break his law. It makes perfect sense. That's why Jesus came, to die for us, to make us at peace with God, to be the bridge. And that is why people all over the world need to hear the good news. There are many objections by Christians to what I am saying right now. That is because they don't know God's love. They have no clue what God's love is. That is because they are lukewarm and they don't know. What are some of the objections? Some people say, oh yeah, well, but there's lots of people here who haven't heard the good news either. Now, this is ridiculous. You know what Jesus said? He said, there are certain cities that Jesus used to preach in called Capernaum and Chorazin and Bethsaida. And Jesus said, woe to Chorazin, woe to Bethsaida. If the mighty works that were done in you had been done in Sodom and Gomorrah, they would have repented in dust and ashes. He said, you are exalted to heaven, but you will be thrown down to hell. What is Jesus saying? Jesus is saying, look at Sodom and Gomorrah, the two cities that God destroyed with fire because they were evil and sinful. Those two cities did not have any of God's law. They didn't even know anything about God's law, and yet God still destroyed them. But these cities that Jesus went to, they knew about God because Jesus was there and he did many miracles. But these cities rejected Jesus' words. So Jesus said the people of Sodom and Gomorrah would have listened, and it will be easier for them on the day of judgment because they didn't have as much knowledge. But you have even more knowledge and you reject it. This is the same thing with North America, Europe, these countries that are saturated with the gospel. Think about it. There are churches on every corner. There's churches everywhere in North and South America. Now, whether these churches are preaching the truth or not is irrelevant at this point. The fact is, people have ample knowledge of the gospel. At least most people in our culture know who Jesus is, who God is, what the Bible is, that Jesus died for our sins, whatever that means. People don't really know, but they have some very generic understanding. And here's the thing, they have ample opportunity to get the gospel. There's so many videos on YouTube to watch. There's Bibles to buy. It's not hard to buy a Bible. It's very accessible. We have Bibles in our language, tons of translations of them. We have tracks, we have books, we have YouTube videos, we have recordings, we have TV programs, we have radio programs. We are inundated with the gospel. We have ample opportunity to seek out the way of salvation in our countries because we are free countries and we have so much accessibility to gospel resources. It's unbelievable. We are saturated. And yet, with all of this, the people in this side of the world, in this part of the world, totally reject it. So whether people hear here or not, they have such opportunity. It is in their hands. And the gospel is being preached like nobody's business in our countries. Is it going down? Yes. But it is everywhere. There are street preachers everywhere. There are Christians evangelizing, preaching the good news everywhere in our countries. But in these other countries that we've talked about, places like the Middle East, Southeast Asia, these other places that have not heard, there is nothing. They don't have Bibles in their language a lot of the time. And even if they do, the accessibility to them is extremely rare. These people have not even heard a single time about the good news. That is insane. That is insane. Imagine there was a beggar. And there was two beggars, okay? There was one beggar way over, or let's make the situation even better. There's one island, okay? The island has tons of bread. And there's beggars on that island, okay? There's tons of bread on that island, but there's still a lot of people who are poor. And then there's another island where there's tons of beggars, tons of poor people, and there's absolutely not a single crumb of food on the entire island. Think about this. Who are you going to feel more bad for? The beggars on the island with tons of bread or the beggars on the island with absolutely nothing? You will look at the beggars on the island with all the bread and say, what is wrong with you? Eat the bread. And if they don't eat it and you keep urging them, you're going to say, well, that's your own fault that you're a beggar. But then you look on the other island, they have nothing. They haven't even had the opportunity to eat and they're starving and dying horrible deaths. Who are you going to feel more bad for and who needs more help? Evidently, the people with absolutely no bread at all. And this is the exact same thing. These people, millions, some would even argue billions of people who have not heard about Jesus Christ's faith even once. And we are so obsessed and selfish that we say, oh, we need to stay here. Now, a lot of people say, oh, it's dangerous. Yes, it is dangerous. But it has always been dangerous. That is the problem. Most people's lives are not dedicated to Jesus Christ. Most people have not left everything behind. Everybody always talks about, let's pray for the missionaries. Let's pray for the laborers. Let's pray for these unreached people and let's give money to missionaries. But if more and more people just say, pray and give, we're not gonna get anywhere. And this is a big problem because a lot of people, they just say, well, I don't feel called to do this. And the number of missionaries, the two biggest countries that give out missionaries are America and Korea. I live in Canada, but we still give out a lot of missionaries too. But a big problem is America, missionaries going down because everybody's just saying pray and give. Same thing with Korea. Everybody's just saying pray and give. And plus the numbers of Christians in this nation is going down too. So God is fed up with this part of the world. He's not using us anymore because we don't want to be used by Him. He's using Christians in that part of the world to do the work because we have been so unfaithful to Him in this regard, so disobedient to Christ's command to spread the good news. God is doing it Himself through people on that side of the world. We are useless. So if you want to be used by God, then really, truly, we need missionaries. There are so many people who have not heard. Pray to God about this. Say, I want to be used by you to tell people about Jesus. Be dedicated to Him. Love Him with everything you have. He will use you. We need more people who will tell the good news. There was a guy named Dwayne Reed, and this is what he said. He said, if you're not trying to go, then at least you could be paying. And if you ain't trying to pay, then at least you could be praying. If not you, not you, then who? If not now, not now, then when? It's competition for their souls, and I'm going for the win. That's what it should be. Now, please, listen to this song and truly think about all the millions of people who have not heard. Yes, it is hard. Yes, it is dangerous. Yes, it is complicated. But at the same time, it's very simple. People are going to hell. They need Jesus. The good news, the love of God. This is the whole point, and this is what the apostles endeavored and laid down their lives to spread. Please think about this. Please truly contemplate if you were going to do this. There's so many preachers just preaching about, yes, we need to do this. We need to reach the unreached. And yet they're not doing anything themselves. And everybody nods their heads and says, yes. And everybody writes books about how we need to reach the unreached and they never go. Something needs to be done. Let's do something and stop talking. Let's ask God, use me in some country that does not have the good news. And a good website you can visit to understand more about the need of this, joshuaproject.com. I urge you to go on that website and look at this.
Every single nation are going to be washed by the blood of the Lamb, and they will see Jesus. They will be in heaven with us. People from every nation and kindred and tongue. This is God's wish, not just for one race or one people, for everybody. Because God does not see labels on people. He sees souls that need to be saved because God loves the world. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Whoever will, let him come and drink of the water of life freely. Let us work to this end and go to the nations that have not heard, because God loves everyone and sent his Son for our sins to be forgiven. Now listen to this song and maybe it will make you think. God bless you.
Do you see all the
you're gonna let them drown.